the sound of the struggle. After 2 decades of service, the Pilipino Workers Center has been in the middle of countless stories like this.
I could take being belittled in front of other people, but I could not take anymore being compensated right. I could not take that. I had my children to support back home.
The PWC marked their 20th anniversary by celebrating their workers' accomplishments. The Los Angeles-based nonprofit has assisted workers, many of them immigrants. They've helped push for legislation for the rights of domestic workers, opened a low-income housing complex, and their jeepney has also helped push Philippine culture through the streets of Los Angeles.
When I first started, no caregiver, no worker wanted to actually, publicly talk about themselves being a caregiver because of the shame. But then now to have workers who are, proclaiming their dignity and really understanding and claiming the value of the work that they do, to me, that makes it all worth it.
While they savor 20 years of accomplishments, they still have work to do, especially as a voice for undocumented immigrants.
More now than ever before, we need to have strong voices around immigrant rights. And PWC, thankfully, is in a position where we can actually be a really strong voice. And so we are being heard by politicians, we are being heard by other organizations, we are being heard across the country.
It's a sentiment that echoes with one of the gala's honorees, undocumented immigrant turned activist, journalist Jose Antonio Vargas.
This is for all the undocumented Filipinos. It is not a time for us to go tago and tago anymore. It is time for us to claim ourselves and claim this country. Because you cannot define American without defining the history of Filipinos in America.
Currently, they're working with city officials on implementing and strengthening recently passed local and statewide sanctuary ordinances. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.